Do you wish to pay your expenses in a less expensive, say, let's completely free way? Or do you intend to replace or upgrade your car? Or to relocate and buy a home? You may have also heard about using the powerful 1099A to accomplish all of these things. You've heard several testimonies about how true and effective it is. You made the decision to take the chance and started your research. Is the time and effort put into this process worthwhile? Will I actually use this 1099A to pay my bills? You just so happen to hear of other people getting into problems when dealing with this process as you were conducting your research. Will I be locked up? Is it possible for me to go through this? Right now, you are overwhelmed by what ifs. Don't worry, though, by watching this video, you are on the right track.
Welcome to Debt Relief and Credit Repair Channel. Your concerns are our answers. The information presented in this video and channel is for informational purposes only. No professional, accounting, financial, investment, or legal advice is given or implied by the channel or moderators.
In response to your financial concerns, we are back with an interesting video. If you are new to this channel, kindly subscribe and share this video with your friends who might find it useful. By doing so, you'll help us keep working toward our goals of providing our viewers with accessible knowledge. Some things might work for others, but some might not work for you. Others may be able to use certain things, but some may not be suitable for you. Does that imply that not everyone will be successful using 1099A to pay their bills? The answer, though, is up to you. Those who got into problems lacked the guts, the knowledge, and the courage to carry on. Don't worry, in this video, we'll discuss the actual steps involved in completing our 1099A form together. It's possible that you've heard a lot of people claim that using your 1099A to pay for a car, a house, or bills is genuinely possible. Just be sure you follow the instructions precisely so that once it is completed, you can confidently take the 1099A to, say, a car dealer. First things first, you must fulfill this crucial condition in order to finish this process. If you live in the US, you must secure your social security number. But if you reside elsewhere, such as the UK, you will require a TIN. You must fill out a W-7 and mail it to the IRS in order to obtain a tax identification number, which you can obtain. There is no online application for this. However, you can use the agents that they have. You'll have to pay. Many of them are charging quite a bit for you to do that. But it's definitely the best option because if you send this over to the mail, you would also need to provide your original identifying documents, such as your passport. By keeping in mind that the mail service in America is incredibly slow, it may take some time to reach there, so you're probably better off using their Certifying Acceptance Agent, or CAAs, which you can find information on the IRS.gov website. There are numerous forms that you must fill out in order to finish this process. The original issue discount, or 1099 OID, is included in some of these forms. When bonds, notes, or certificates of deposits are sold at a discount from their maturity value, original issue discount income must be reported on Form 1099 OID, original issue discount. If you are mailing your yearly information returns to the IRS, you also need to complete Form 1096. Additionally, you will require the IRS 1040 form, which is one of the recognized records used by American citizens to submit their annual income tax returns. The Form 56, which notifies the IRS of the establishment or termination of fiduciary relationship under Section 6903, is the most vital document you will require. Yes, even though we provide knowledge that is easy to follow, you should always conduct your own research to ensure that you thoroughly understand the entire procedure and can be successful. Many people are in awe that this powerful 1099A can actually purchase a car. However, a lot of people are also concerned that they might get into difficulties since some of their process did not work out. Is the 1099A form to blame? No. Their failure to follow the proper procedure is their responsibility. You must adhere to a procedure outlined by the IRS, which may include filling out several documents. Also required is a trustee. In a way, you are on your own banking institution. So if you don't want to worry about a trustee, you may get your own bankers, employer identification number, and do it yourself. There has been a lot of uncertainty and a lot of people claiming to have cars, but none has presented any sort of proof to back up their claims. Some people have, however, demonstrated that they do really own cars. However, we are unaware of the transpired thereafter. However, those who accepted this risk with less understanding are having problems since they did not plan a strategy, which is why they lacked information. It is crucial that you use a trustee to clear the funds throughout the process. A 1099A can pay bills. Yes, you simply need to choose someone as a trustee, preferably someone who works for a financial investment company or other type of financial organization that will agree, and preferably someone who's not currently a part of the current system, meaning someone who has essentially broken free from it. Are you now prepared to accept the risk and take pleasure in your new home or car? Start your investigation about this procedure by visiting www.1099online.com. To take on all the labor would be quite inconvenient for you. You want to save money, yet it can be difficult to allow yourself to pay to fulfill tax law requirements. This is how the website appears. Since we are concentrating on Form 1099A, click Forms in the upper left corner of the tabs. You will then have access to information on what Form 1099A is, when it must be filed, how it interacts with Form 1099C, and who is required to file Form 1099A. It appears that you can also use this to pay bills, so prepare who you are going to write in regarding who is the lender and who is the borrower. When using this to pay your bills, you play the part of the lender, and the people you are paying play the part of the borrowers. Be aware that if you submit a form using this website, 1099online.com will typically approve it in 2 to 3 business days. Remember not to check the 5th box on the form 1099A if you are paying bills, since you are the lender and the recipients of your payments are the borrowers. They will assume accountability. However, if you are purchasing a home, it appears that the IRS or the Treasury will be disbursing the funds. And as I previously stated, I understand that you require a trustee to clear it. Many people are eager to fill out these forms and submit them to sellers. The problem, in my belief, has been that people haven't been done their research before getting enthusiastic and bringing these forms to dealers who don't really know what this form is. Small businesses may be filling out the wrong forms and do not understand their process at the very moment. Therefore, it is crucial that you conduct your research before you touch anything. You could choose to use the online system, which takes 2 to 3 days to accept the 1099A and is, I believe, linked to the Treasury Office or the IRS. We are all in this together. While we learn more about it, you might as well leave a comment to help us improve our content. I sincerely hope today was beneficial to you. I sincerely hope I piqued your interest and motivated you to share this information with everyone who might find it useful. Thank you for watching this video. Make sure you click the subscribe button on this channel to avoid missing anything. A ton of free information is available on this channel. Take action right away with it. Let's continue the fight. Once more, this is the Debt Relief and Credit Repair channel. See you in our next video.